Yeah, that, not too many people know the north rim. Everybody uses the south rim.
Yes.
So how'd you like the north rim?
I like it. Because you go, I wrote it on the internet, you go through a very wide land, lots of trees, grassland. It's beautiful, and you're nothing thinking about there can be a stop somewhere. And then you go in the forest, and suddenly it's broken, and there is the Grand Canyon right in front of you, and you can't get on. And the South Rim, if you look over Grand Canyon, South Rim is just 14 kilometers far away. And I told talked to Julia and said, what about the old settlers when they came down there and with their horses, with their big wagons caught by horses, and they tried to go there, and then so, oh, it stopped.
They had to stop?
Yes. And the, and then we looked on the map, and we have to go from North Rim to South Rim, just 14 kilometers to see. It's a trip on more than 330 kilometers. Other more than 200 miles to get there, and it's only possible because there are two big bridges over the Colorado and another river.
Yes.
So they all say they have to go, I think, a year to move around Grand Canyon. So it was amazing. It was so big.
Very good. And then from the Grand Canyon, did you stop at a little town that had wild donkeys?
Yes, yes, yes. So after North Rim, we went to South Rim, Grand Canyon then.
Okay.
I looked on the map, and we are a motorbiker, and so the famous route to drive for a motorbiker is Route 66. I think everybody who drives a motorbike has to ride Route 66, and so we did it from Grand Canyon, a little bit south of Grand Canyon. We went on Route 66 all the way to Los Angeles, and on the halfway, I think in the desert, the Mojave Desert, we went up to the hills, and when we came down, there was a very bad town. I didn't like it, and we just came around the corner. It was so beautiful. There are donkeys on the street, lot of them, and it was so funny. It, like, it looks like an old western town.
Yes.
A shop, and it was amazing, really amazing. Right in the desert, and that's Old Man. It's next to Needles, I think.
Yes. Did the donkeys come up to you?
Yes.
Did they beg for food?
Yes, yeah. They just want to have food, lots of food. They told us they are old mine donkeys. And when the mines were closed, they put all the donkeys, they sent them away, and they settled down in the hills, in the desert. And you know, now they go always down to the tourists to get some food.
Yes, they stop, they go on the streets, they stop the cars, no, cars have to wait until they cross the street.
Yes,
yes.
That's Old Man.
Yeah, we like Old Man, we go there all the time.
Yes, and then we wanted to go to Los Angeles, and we stopped in Needles. Julia told me, oh, let's go to the motel. We stopped right in front of a motel, and I looked at my watch and said, no, let's have another hour drive, because it's we want to not next day we want to go to Los Angeles, and when we drive now an hour, we save it to, for tomorrow. And I looked on my map, and there are several towns on my map from at Route 66, and so in one of those towns we can find a motel. It's not a big problem, and we drove, and we saw towns, but they are all ghost towns at Route 66, and it became hotter and hotter because it was a desert too. Our gas nearly goes to its end, and I was very afraid of all this situation because there was nothing to find. And Julia told me, it's no problem, we will camp down there. I said, no, camping in the desert, there are lots of rattlesnakes, I don't like them.
Also scorpions.
Also.
Yes.
And so we were lucky to find just one house where somebody lives. It was a gas station. And he told us there are 30 more miles and we can find a motel in Ludo.
Yes.
Yes.
Very good. And then you made it to Los Angeles.
Yes.
Very good.
Los Angeles is a nice town. It's a real big town. It's very good.
Okay, good. Okay, so that brings us up to date. And